Hey guys, welcome back to Portsmouth, New Hampshire. Hope you enjoyed the last video. It was a lot different than our other videos. Some of it was the same, but some of it was different. There was just more of it, I guess. The in-betweens is what I'm talking about. A lot of people wanted to see more of, behind the scenes or in-betweens of us traveling from Florida to New Hampshire. What happens in between? So hopefully we did that justice and did a good job in the last video, and you liked it and you gave us a thumbs up, and maybe you subscribed to our channel if you aren't already subscribed to our channel. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button now. Hit that like button anytime throughout the process. So 3 weeks ago, Amy and I were here in Portsmouth, New Hampshire. 3 weeks ago. And 3 weeks ago, we didn't take the van. We didn't travel in a van. We decided to go by airplane. And this is what it looked like. Flying to Boston. We're getting on a plane. Boston. Down in Boston, and plane ride wasn't that bad.
Our car.
Matt, no double D open either.
Overnight stay in a motel in Boston, Massachusetts, which was it was a nice hotel. The next morning was really cool because we woke up and out of our window in our room and see the harbor, Boston Harbor, and I saw this water taxi, and it was just fascinating to me to see it because it carried people across the river. That's what a water taxi does, I guess. The little things fascinate me, so. It's pretty cool. We don't have those in Florida. I don't see water taxis taking people across the harbor in Florida. So next, we were hopping in our Jeep and heading up north. We were going to Maine. So we had a couple days before we had to be back to Portsmouth, New Hampshire. So we decided to go to Bar Harbor. And we made a pit stop in York, Maine. We are going to try this cool little burger joint on the side of the road because we're hungry. How's your hamburger? We went to Bar Harbor. Amy rented us a cabin at a KOA there. We wanted to check out this KOA. We didn't camp there the last time we were there, but we plan to come back up to Maine and Canada next year. So we wanted to just scope it out and see, you know, if this would, and it turned out to be a very nice KOA. However, the cabins, Amy forgot, when you rent a cabin at the KOA, they don't come with blankets and sheets and pillows, and it was a little chilly, so yeah, it was cold. Unloaded our stuff in the cabin, hopped back in the Jeep, ran into Bar Harbor, only a few miles away. We found our favorite seafood place and we had some lobster. It was delicious. Mm-mm. We went back to the cabin and we had a great night's sleep. No, not really. We didn't. I mean, Amy was out, but I didn't sleep at all, really, to be honest. And we headed back into Bar Harbor to find some breakfast, and we ended up finding Maine breakfast, Maine, like the state Maine. And I highly recommend this. Amy does too, but it is a great restaurant. We went in this little breakfast nook, and the food was so delicious, and I even partook in some pumpkin pancakes, which I had never had before. Have you guys had any? If you haven't, try them, because they're very delicious. So the idea wasn't to stay in Bar Harbor, only like a couple days. We wanted to mostly explore Bar Harbor and do a couple things we hadn't done before, but we had to get a glimpse of Acadia National Park. There's a place in town where you can walk out in the tide, in the harbor, the tide goes out and it leaves this whole barren area full of rocks, and it's kind of muddy, but there's a bunch of rocks, and you can actually, twice a day, say there's 3 hours, you have a 3 hour period that you can walk across the harbor on these rocks, and you see all these seagulls just swimming in, they're catching these crabs and just having meals, crabs. I wanted to join in, but I was already full from lunch. But and then on the other side is Bar Harbor Island, which you can only get to when the tide's out. How many times a day does this happen?
Twice a day.
So what happens?
When it's low tide, it washes it all out, and then you can walk across it.
So there was water here just a couple hours ago? The island, Mar Island. There's usually water, and there's Bar Harbor. Pretty cool. Everywhere. Where is it?
A mile.
About a mile?
Yeah.
You really have to concentrate on where you're walking.
Is actually owned by Acadia National Park, and you go over there, you have this 3-hour period, and we spent time on the other side, we spent time in the middle, we spent time everywhere just sitting and finding spots to look out across the harbor. It was just beautiful. And then once you get to the other side, there's a hike, and it's about a half a mile up to the summit, and you can look down over the entire Bar Harbor area. If you don't, for some reason you don't time it right, you have to, I guess, call an Uber to come get you, like an Uber boat. I don't know what they call it. Water taxi. You have to get a water taxi, and it's like really expensive, like $50 or more. And hopefully you have cell service so you can call the water taxi to come get you off the island and bring you back to Bar Harbor. I don't know. But we had enough time and we made it. We made it back across, and it was just one of those bucket list items we didn't get a chance to do before, and we didn't even know it was right there in the town. If you're ever in Bar Harbor, make sure you check out when the tides go out. And when you can walk across to the Bar Harbor Island, because it's really cool, really cool. So we opted to take the 1-mile trail to the summit of Bar Harbor Island. So we're almost there to the top. Time to head back in before we get stuck out here. Unless you want to stay out here.
No. Yeah. It's pretty though.
It's very pretty. We're heading back across the bay, the harbor.